So it's 5 a.m. These people are asking, like, where next? Like, what spot is popping next? It's 5 a.m. What next? Next. There's nothing next. Let's go home and go to sleep. I'm tired.
What's up, everybody? I'm still in Ghana, man. Beautiful over here. It's beautiful in Ghana. But look, quick story time. So anybody that knows me knows I eat like a toddler, man. It ain't too much I eat. So needless to say, the way I've been eating over here, my stomach been a little messed up. I've been a little backed up over here. So I went to the pharmacy. Now over here, you could just walk in the pharmacy. The pharmacy like the liquor store. You could just walk in and get whatever. So I go in the pharmacy. I tell my man, I say, my man, I'm a little backed up, man. You got anything for constipation? That nigga said, yes, yes. I was like, God damn, that nigga sound like Tales from the Hood. He must have made this himself. He was like, yes, take 3 of these tablets. Just take 3 of these tablets before you go to sleep. I was like, bet. Took out a sheet. He opened the box and just sold me a sheet. Didn't even make me buy the whole box. Shit was like $9. Anyway, I get back to the room. Swear to God, I took 3 of these tablets. Soon as I swallowed these bitches, the doo-doo started coming out. I was like, God damn. These must be rapid release. I almost had the shit in the sink, nigga. Man, listen, I don't know what that man gave me, but God bless you, Slim. I know in America, you got to have a prescription for that shit, and it probably costs $500. Salute to my man in the 3 tablets. I hope everybody's enjoying their 2024. Woo!
So I've come to explore by myself because the festivities with Topical doesn't begin till tomorrow. But I think we're going to go out tonight once everyone arrives for their destinations. Someone recommended Sandbox, but the guy said Sandbox don't get popping till 6, so I may go there later. So I'm at this place called Alora, but they have an event. I'm not sure what the event's called. I think it's called Afro something. I don't know what it's called, but I'm at their beachfront. I really wanted to see the beach, but the beach is so freaking beautiful. And I think I underestimated how high it was going to be. Look at my outfit, it's boiling. Let me show you. Look how gorgeous the beach is. Like, I'm really tempted to go on a horse, but I'm a bit scared, child, but it's so beautiful.
Listen, Charlie. It seems like I'm in Ghana, but I am not in Ghana. Because, trust me, some of the videos that I see these diasporans post is just crazy. Like, it makes me feel like, Charlie, I'm not in Ghana. The way they come here, they enjoy themselves, and literally, Ghana has actually become, especially every December, has become one of the destinations for enjoyment and chilling and bro, like, it's for everybody. I mean everybody that wants, you know, when it's time approaching December, a lot of them, you'll see them on social media being like, the flight ticket is expensive, I cannot come, and but wait until December starts, from 1st to the 31st, and you will start seeing them trooping in like nobody's business. Listen, I'm here to share with you some of the videos or some of the experiences of some, like, some of these diasporans in Ghana. Listen, when you are not in Ghana every December, you are missing out a lot. Check these videos out.
Waking up 3 days after New Year's Eve in Ghana. Like, I'm done. I'm going back to sleep. You can wake me up next year, December, because this is not normal. How am I supposed to go to work? I'm supposed to go to work today. Hey, my boss calling me this morning. I'll be like, boss, I'm sorry, I'm sick. Ghana, I beg you, you can't do this. How are you guys doing this? This is not meant for being like this. Ah.
you know what I realized? You guys need to hold your phones when you go on holiday. Just hold your phones. Like, I'm trying to post my snaps from yesterday at Castle White because I'm in Ghana. And all I can hear the DJs going, oh, him, if you lost your iPhone 14, oh, him, come to the bar. Oh, him, if you lost your Samsung, oh, him, like, can you guys hold your phone? Like, I can't even finish the song in peace. Like, I'm just trying to post one snap and everyone's using their 14, their Samsung. Hey, just hold on to your phone.
Whoever said the men in Ghana wasn't tricking is going to hell for fucking lying. Because I haven't spent not a dollar yet. Yes, I am still on track to finding y'all husbands, but first, I gotta get me. So yeah, I started the day, my first day, by, you know, getting ready. I'm thinking, okay, it's gonna be a little cute night out. It's only our first day. I was really excited, but y'all, I was sadly mistaken. By the time y'all get to the end of this video, y'all gonna figure out what the fuck I'm talking about. But I had to make sure everything was laid, did my edges and everything. I was giving, made me sweat, made me hotter. That's what I was giving. Made me lose my breath. Look at that body, bitch. Don't play with it. Don't play with it. Just stay with it. I had to go, you know, I'm the poster girl for us. So I gotta go out looking good so they can whop. So we took pictures, and then after that, this is where my night started. No telling where your night is going to end when you're in Ghana. Honestly, I should have known better when the pregame started at 2 a.m. So we went to get these cute drinks at a pregame, and I'm thinking, once again, all right, tonight gonna be cool. Now, the food in Ghana is a 1100 out of 10. Every time they put something in my face, I'm tearing that shit up every single time without fail. Anyways, we got a few shots. When I say a few, it was like two apiece. Like, that's crazy. Then we headed to the real club at 4 a.m., y'all. Like, I should have known once I was walking down this hallway what type of night tonight was going to be. 5 a.m., 6 a.m., they still get looking bottles. I'm trying to hang on, y'all. I'm trying to hold on. But honestly, this my eighth glass looking champagne. What is going on? 5 o'clock in the morning, more bottles coming. Okay, 7 a.m. we leaving the club. Cool, let's go home. You thought you wrong. We done pulled up to another spot. At this point, I'm mind blown. It's 7:51. We just got to brunch. Bring me the hookah. We gonna brunch. Let's brunch it up. But Ghana is not a real place. Daddy December is. I can't even grab the cup. Look at that. I can't even grab the cup. But I can't let them think I'm no asshole. So shit. I just kept the food. I'm telling. For real, I know I've been this food up. Home at 9:30 in the morning, and this is just day one. I can only imagine what the rest of this trip holds. You told Ghana to beat me? No, for real though, who told Ghana to beat my ass like this? I had to start my day off with some food to bounce back. No, I ate that up, and then we got ready for what I thought I was ready for. I thought, okay, last night we stayed out to the sun up, tonight we're gonna stay out to the sun up. I'm ready. I was sadly mistaken again. Outfit is definitely giving Atlanta rapper baby mama. But it still gave. It was cute. It was cute. We did bring in the new year at home. So we stayed in, watched the fireworks, and then it was time to go out. Look at that body. God damn, Des. So our taxi came to pick us up and then we headed to the first place. To the next place?
Yeah.
What time they close?
6, 7.
7 a.m.
Yeah. New Year's Eve.
But I am telling you right now, that mother back there is not real.
Bus, another club. No sleep. Another club. Bus, another club. No sleep. I was so ready to tap out, but they literally would not let me. So we went to another place. Another day, like I did it. We gone, it's time to go home. I was about to tap out. Y'all thought it was over? We pulled up to another club after that club. Oh, God. It's morning time and these motherfuckers are still going. It's 8 o'clock in the morning, almost 9 o'clock in the morning. I said, let's do it.
It's 8 o'clock in the morning. I'm not even ready to go home.
What do you say?
I checked my bank account and I ain't spent not a dollar yet. Y'all husbands really been looking out for me while I'm here in Ghana. These genres though, not mine. Of course I had to give me some motherfucking food and then guess what? After that I got some
I know I just ate a burger, but them wings from KFC. KP, I want the wings.
Fire.
I want the wings.
After I got my wings, we finally went home. We got home about 10 a.m. I woke up the next day at like 5 p.m. to this text. Come get your husband, bruh. At this rate, do y'all think I'm gonna make it? Be honest! The way I almost got pregnant in Ghana today should be a sin. For real. Kids out of wedlock. Cause what the hell? But first I had to go get me some food. We went to this bakery that we seen on the side of the road. And everything in here was so freaking fresh. Like, this not that Subway. Like, they cut that right in front of you. And y'all know I order everything off the meal because I'm just a fat ass. My cousin Mimi was with us today. She was acting right today, y'all. Y'all know she wasn't acting right last time. But look at how fresh everything is just. And we ate and headed to our destination. I'm not gonna lie to y'all, I'm not no nature ass bitch. Like, Mimi is a nature ass bitch. She's so excited. And I'm just walking like, what the fuck? But then we seen these kids and I was recording them and he like, what the fuck? Why the fuck are you recording me? So I apologize for that, for real. Once I seen this right here, I said, oh yeah, it's time. One of y'all about to be my baby daddy. Who about to be my mother baby daddy around this? Because these were some other people getting their massages. I was ready for them to hurry up. Then when they was done, they came over and I can't even talk. Anyways, it was my turn to lay on the bed. And all I could think in my head was, and touch my body, lay me on the floor, toss me around and play with me some more.
So many reasons why I want to for you, my love. Now you I want to retire with you, my love. See all the cuckoo things you do, they make me know that. Oh no, no. This distance is taking a hold of me for sure. Baby, come, Mulosa. I want you to make me day, Mulosa. Girl, I want to make you Mulosa.
He must have really liked Mimi because he is taking care of her mother's body. Like, damn. I know Mimi pregnant too, but such a great experience. I got to experience all sides of Ghana, from the nightlife to the... Ooh. Ooh, message. She, ooh,
This is me coming home at 7 a.m. after a night of clubbing in Ghana, but we're going to get into everything that transpired before that. So we're at Laura Beach Club for New Year's. I start off with a glass of wine and some mini pancakes just to get me going. I think I'm by myself for 10 minutes, get invited to a section. He buys the full bottle of wine that I'm drinking. I finish the whole bottle by myself. Once the clock strikes midnight, then everything starts rocking. I run into Hannah, who I met while I was out here. She actually just moved to Ghana. She's super lit. Now I'm in Hannah's section. They got a lot of champagne in Hannah's section, so I'm popping bottles. I'm drinking champagne. At this point, I am very lit, okay? I did not expect to get to this level, so I'm like, you know what? Let me escort myself to the bathroom and just take a moment to calm down, okay? This may have been a mistake in and of itself. I get in the bathroom. I'm making eye contact with myself in the mirror in the bathroom for 15 minutes. Don't even realize that time is flying by in here. I'm making friends. After a while, I eventually dance my way back to the table safely. When I tell you the music in all these clubs goes crazy, I literally mean that. Someone gave me a fan because I was literally getting so hot, so shout out to him. He was like Dutch. I don't know his name. I didn't get his name. Now, this man here is literally doing portraits of people as they're sitting down, so I was like, okay, I'm definitely going to be next. I sit for like, I don't even know how long. I was honestly too intoxicated to remember, but this is the portrait after. Shout out to him, and I'm not going to lie, I had an amazing night. Left at 7 a.m. Come with me to Polo Beach Club in Accra, Ghana. This was the fit of the night. Dresses from Fashion Nova. I pull up. The first thing I'm looking for is a menu because I need food and drinks stat. I tell the bartender to surprise me with something sweet. He hits a nail on the head. The drink was absolutely delicious. My mom and I ordered fried rice and octopus. The presentation was a 10 out of 10. The octopus tastes just like chicken. I kid you not. Then I take a tour of the facilities. The club is connected straight to the beach. I'm headed out. I'm on the sand for 0.5 seconds when Derek rides up to me on his stallion. Next thing you know, 155 pounds of Trini Jackson is being lifted up onto his horse, okay? It is what it is. Winning Ghana is all I've been saying. I'm on the beach. I'm riding a horse. I thank him for his time, and then I'm kicking my feet in the water a little bit. The sand was so hot. The water was so warm. Beach, absolutely beautiful. I get back to the table. My mom already has another drink waiting on me. We order some shrimp tempura. We obviously hated it. Obviously disgusting. I took a nap on this little bed that I found. By the time I woke up, I had to catch back up, got some pizza and a couple more shots. I don't know when I got so intoxicated that I started texting people, but I think it was around this point in time, because anytime I'm starting to look at my reflection a little too much, I'm already where I need to be and I need to stop drinking. They had bottled boys at the club, which I actually love, because if you have a six pack, you can definitely serve me some drinks. It is what it is. I'm surprised I was even able to capture this much of the night. I'm dancing. I'm standing in one's couches. We were going up until 7 a.m. Best night of my life.
Is that long? This is 12 hours. 12 hours of party. Ghana is built different. Not built for it. I just needed to experience it just one time. Just one time. I'm good. I just walked in the house at 7 a.m. and I left the house at 7 p.m. yesterday. Good morning and good night.
My love, see, I did the good things you do, they make me know. Oh, no. Drifting in opera.
Opera.
December is not for the weak. Day December is not for the weak.
Okay, so I just got back to LA from Ghana. I was there for 11 days solo. And since I was there for 11 days, here are some tips I'm gonna give you for anybody that's gonna go in 2024 this December. I highly suggest just save this video. First things first, the best dates to go is anywhere from December 22nd through January 10th. So anywhere within that time frame, I personally think is the best time to go. Exchanging money in Ghana is fairly easy. I highly suggest only exchanging $400 at a time because it's a little bit more difficult to exchange it back into USD. Also, they don't take old bills or like dirty, messed up bills. So make sure your bills are new and very crisp. Also, make sure you're exchanging 50s and 100s because you'll get a better rate on bigger bills. Depending on how long you stay, I highly suggest to bring about $700 to $1,500. Ghana is expensive. There's no easier way to put that. Ghana is expensive. The parties range from $40 to $60, sometimes $80. Dollars depending on who's throwing it and if it's New Year's or not. I definitely feel like the party promoters and organizations from the US and the UK be getting over on us because we don't pay that shit back home. However, I'm gonna let it slide because we ain't gonna and we having a lit time. But yeah, the parties are expensive. And just calculate that into your budget. Okay, don't be like me and only pack one pair of sandals. Make sure you have sandals that you can wear to the club, sandals you can wear to brunch, sandals that you could go absolutely anywhere in, because the terrain in Ghana is not made for heels. However, still bring your heels because you're still going to want to get your outfits off. But some of your days may look like you wake up at 10 a.m. and then don't go to sleep till 10 a.m. the next day. I highly suggest that you overpack. 3 outfits per day, bare minimum. That's just how it is. And your day may look like you wake up for breakfast or brunch. That's a different outfit. Then you have an event to go to. That's a different outfit. And then you're going out to a party or a club. That's a totally different outfit. So just overpack. Also, while you're overpacking, make sure you have at least three all-white outfits. One thing about Ghana loves an all-white event. When I say I packed three all-white outfits and went to three all-white events, and then I saw some more all-white events while I was leaving, like, bare minimum three all-white outfits, and then maybe like two all-black outfits, because there are some all-black events here and there. Okay, so another tip, very niche tip, is having a bad bitch attitude. You know that attitude, like that BBL attitude, where it's like, you just don't talk to nobody and you just sit pretty the entire time. That shit does not work in Ghana. Baby, you about to miss blessings and opportunities looking pretty. If you don't get up, dance, have fun, and vibe, like, the energy in Ghana is like, people talk to people. People dance with people. People meet people. Having that, I'ma sit on this sofa or sit in the cut and not talk and just look cute, you not go get anywhere with that. When I tell you, it's so easy to get in a section by just smiling and speaking. Like, it's so easy. Okay, so this tip is directed more towards Americans, because I feel like in other countries, people use WhatsApp more frequently than we do. We really don't use it like that in the country. So make sure you download WhatsApp. Also, make sure you call your cell phone carrier and ask them about international packages that they have. I know with Verizon, we get 5 days for free with our travel package, and then every day after that is the extra $10 to use your data. I did not do that last year and was just using my data without using WhatsApp, and ended up racking up a $500 phone bill. So don't be like me. Be smarter. Ladies, if you're gonna get your hair done in Ghana, which you 10 times out of 10 are, make it a full day thing. Don't be like me and have your hair plan and then an event plan and then partying plan, because that did not go as planned and I missed two functions that I really wanted to go to because I thought my hair would be done even if I went to the shop at 6 a.m. And also, don't just go to Ghana to party. There is so much to do in Ghana. Like, I took a cooking class. I signed up for a chocolate making class. I ended up missing it because of my hair appointment. I saw a chocolate tasting class. I saw brunches that help people to invest and also taught people how to move there. Like, just look for events outside of partying. That way your whole trip will be well-rounded. And okay, so that's all my tips for DETTY December for 2024. I hope to see you guys there in December, because I'm going back this year. I'm gonna be there. But you know, just start saving your money, get everything in play right now so I can see you there.
We get asked this question a lot because we go to countries where it's frowned upon to be gay or homosexual by law, but also in culture. We just came back from Ghana recently. We went for DETTY December. To set context, we're based in the UK. We're a married couple. So we want to share experience of what it was like being a tourist in Ghana. Also understand what the laws are over there.
Yeah, so I think in our experience, it was safe. But, like, certain rules had to be obeyed and followed for us to, like, have a safe experience out in Ghana. So, for instance, we went to this queer-friendly club, or club that we were told was queer-friendly, last Saturday. We got into the club, one of our friends put us on the guest list. Like, the queue was crazy, but we were able to get in, thankfully. And we head to this one room, which feels more of a safe space than the rest of the club. Like, I feel like the rest of the club was quite traditional in, like, DETTY December. It felt very hetero, felt very, like, DETTY December vibes. But we're in this one room, which felt like a safe space. We can see there are other queer people in the space, like, dancing with each other. T and I, we're very expressive, so we were dancing with each other as well. But then at one point, T leans over and gives me a peck on the lips. And at that point, we just feel like the energy shift a bit, and it felt like folks dispersed around us. And I didn't actually notice it until T called it out. And I was just like, okay, cool, just like continue dancing. And then the next day we went for breakfast with one of our friends who wasn't at the club at the time. And then we're telling him, hey, we're at this club. And he was like, oh, I already know. And we're like, oh, how do you know? And he said, like, people at the club essentially told him that the TikTok couple were in the club lip-syncing each other. And we were just like, wow. So this is like a space that is a queer-friendly space. And the fact that that news got out in that way means that there's certain like rules that we have to obey, and that I think gave us more of an understanding around how LGBTQ plus people are gonna navigate their sexualities in public, and certain like certain rules and boundaries that you don't cross, which makes sense. And I think from then on, we navigated it a bit differently. So
I think to answer the question, like, as tourists, our experience, it was safe for us in Ghana, in terms of we did not experience overt homophobia or anything mm-hmm. like that. And I think that there, like Andrew said, there are rules that you follow. Like, public display of affection is not necessarily something you should be comfortable doing there,
mm.
or you are comfortable with doing there. And I think for us, something I just remembered is, like, when we go to countries like Paris or Barcelona, two black gay men holding hands, it's also, yeah, we get looks, stares. We get stares.
A lot, yeah.
So I would say that in Ghana, definitely was safe for us. As tourists, this is not from a local experience at all. We just want to put that disclaimer out there. But yeah, I think public display of affection is something you keep to queer-friendly spaces, but not...
Even then.
Yeah, but even then, respect the boundaries. But yeah, cool.
Charlie. Next year, this year, December, I need to represent, because I can't be in my country and diasporans will come and enjoy the country like this and I will be lonely in the house. No, I have to. Thank you so much for watching.